Why Red Sox? About 5 years ago, we saw that the fight against malware was an uneven battle. And in a fast-changing world, the challenge would only become bigger due to the increase in bandwidth, the increase in diversity in traffic, trends like bring your own device and the Internet of Things. We foresaw that the more traditional and mainly preventive measures would no longer be sufficient, since most threats would still enter the network if they're not already in there. And you would enter the network often not even through the front door. We then realized that there was a need for a completely new approach, one that would look beyond the traditional scope and boundaries. So we stepped away from looking at the traffic content and focused mainly on behavior and destinations of connections to the internet. And by doing just so, we became able to pick malicious indicators from large bulks of data, not being hindered by new protocols or the use of any type of encryption. The results of the first time real-life test back in 2013 were overwhelming, and this motivated us to take ThreatSox to the next level. How do we do it? Well, we collect, share and produce a lot of threat intelligence on an exceptionally large scale. We have a dedicated team of highly skilled employees who monitor a few hundred thousand botnets in real time. We analyze up to 1 million pieces of malware every day and push all this intelligence directly to our clients. Another team of experts writes heuristic algorithms used to find patterns in the cached metadata. The metadata is an IPFix format and is extracted from a client's network. All this threat intelligence and all these algorithms are being pushed continuously via one-way communication to our clients, as being correlated on-site with the metadata, which is an IPFix format, extracted from the client's network. This way we cover all types of endpoints, and we find a tremendous amount of malware, which you call generic malware, but also APT actors, patient zero infections, and other types of hostile behavior. I would certainly like to emphasize that since we strongly believe in European values towards privacy, we do not extract any information from our client networks, period. A few years ago, it was much more difficult to scout talent since we were still in our startup phase. Nowadays, ThreatSox is well known in the community and talent knows where to find us. We do still, however, scout for new talent universities throughout the Netherlands. And we also have a handful of employees working remotely from across the world. The number of ThreatSox employees doubles every year, and it's wonderful to see how we all embrace the company's mission, vision, and share the same values. We are convinced, we all are, that our approach is future-proof and will last for at least 2 more decades.